G'day guys, Dr. James Simcock here, and just going to do another short story for our YouTube members. It seems like this week all I've done is assess dogs with hip dysplasia, either for candidacy for double pelvic osteotomy or possibly total hip replacement. I've got about, I think, six cases this week that have come in for assessment. So I've seen that and TPLO, so I haven't got a lot of new and exciting stuff to show you, but I just had an interesting case today. Which was an 11-month-old golden retriever that presented for assessment of hip dysplasia. And this dog presented, had a kind of long history of no overt lameness per se. The owners really reported that the biggest problem was a kind of marked hip sway when he's walking. And they commented that he looks like an old man when he's trying to get up and down onto the sofa, and also when he's trying to get up and down off the ground. So he went to the regular vet and had some x-rays taken. The x-rays were nice quality, and they had a lateral and extended hip view and basically showed that there wasn't a lot of secondary arthritis, on the radiographs at least. And what we could see is that there was fairly poor coverage of the femoral head with the acetabulum. So I had a long chat to the owners about the different options and talked about the steps that I like to go through if we're looking at working these cases up for a double pelvic osteotomy. And for me, there's a couple of things that are very important, and I have talked about this to you guys before. The first thing is to palpate an Ortolani sign. If they've got a positive Ortolani sign with a nice, very apparent click or popping sensation when we check for that angle of reduction and subluxation, that's the first thing. Second thing is that I want to make sure that they have no radiographic arthritis, and the most sensitive way to do that is on a CT scan. The third thing I want to look at is the distraction index, and we want to have a distraction index less than 0.7. And then the fourth thing that we want to look at is, and it's less important for me, is that angle of reduction and subluxation when we're doing the Ortolani sign. So for this dog, we could palpate an Ortolani sign, and this was where it was interesting, because on the left side, he had a very crisp Ortolani sign. So this hip would reduce out, sorry, subluxate out, and then as we abducted the knee, it would reduce back in, and had a very very clear clicking or popping Ortolani sign when we did that. And what's interesting here is that when we look at the dorsal acetabular rim, which is this section here, we can see the kind of tip of that rim, and there's really nice and smooth, and it's a, just a rounded kind of tip to that acetabulum. Compared to the other side, where you can see it's actually a little bit blunted. I'll have to maybe zoom in a bit here so you can see a bit better, but you can just make out, if I come back out a bit, that it's a little bit blunted in this section just here. And that blunting is a suggestion that there's actually some arthritis here. We can also see a bit of an osteophyte here. So in this case, we had a very nice crisp Ortolani sign on this left side, but on the right side, we didn't actually have a crisp Ortolani. I could feel the hip subluxating, but when I tried to reduce it, it was just kind of this very soft kind of reduction of the hip into the joint. So that tells me straight away that dog has probably got some changes in this in the capsule and the soft tissues that would preclude him from being a good candidate on that side. So as we did the CT scan, we could see here that there is some osteophytes and some arthritis, and it is more apparent on this right side. You can see that there's a couple of osteophytes on the femoral head and neck here, around the femoral head there, and then on the acetabulum here. So spoke to the owner and said, look, the right side is not one I would do a double pelvic osteotomy on. I think that's too far gone. The left side, however, I'm pretty happy that there's not a lot of secondary arthritic change on this side. So what we've done then, so the fourth thing I like to look at is the dorsal acetabular rim angle. So the Ortolani sign, whether it's positive or negative, and as I say, I don't put too much weight on whether on what the angles of reduction and subluxation are. So when we look then at the acetabular rim, I like to get these guys lined up. So I've got the pelvis nice and straight. I actually bring the calipers over here and make sure that I'm in the center of the acetabulum. So we can see here we want to move up just to the center of the acetabulum, so right around there. And then we come back here and we want to measure this dorsal acetabular rim angle. So this is how we're going to plan our double pelvic osteotomy. So again, I've been through this before with you guys. So we put our angle markers on here like this. I'm going to bring that up here and get it accurate. And then we're going to bring this line. Oops. This isn't going to work too well for a second. Bring that out of the way. Bring that down there. Grab onto this one. So I'm going to bring this line along here and work out exactly where this angle makes what the dorsal acetabular ring angle is here compared to the nice straight pelvis. So the angle that we've got here is about 16 degrees. So we are planning to do a DPO on this left hip, and the plate that I'm going to use is going to be probably somewhere between a 20 and a 25 degree plate. So I'm going to go with a 25 plate. So I'm going to get that dog in 2 weeks' time for surgery. I will film that surgery and live stream it, but just wanted to run through this interesting case with you and the fact that the dog had normal x-rays or very normal looking x-rays, but we kind of upped the ante with the investigation that we do, and we've had a close look at this guy. He's got one hip that is a good candidate, this left side, the other hip's not a good candidate. And I really don't think you'd be able to get that level of detail short of doing the kind of investigation that we've done with a CT scan and careful palpation. So hopefully that was interesting for you. I have to rush into another surgery now. It's a TPLO, so I'm not going to live stream that one because we did one yesterday. And I'm trying to keep things a bit more interesting for you guys. So hopefully that was helpful. And if you have any questions about that, certainly feel free to reach out to us. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Cheers.